Welcome back to presentation on the module 4, that is torsion. In the previous lecture, we studied about the basic concepts of torsion. What are the effects of the torque applied on a shaft? And we studied some formula related to that. So in this lecture 6, we'll be studying the important derivations of torsion equation and related problems on this one. Now, let us consider a shaft. You can see here, this is a shaft of diameter D and length L is fixed at one end and a torque is applied in a clockwise direction at the other end. We can see the torque here. And we can see that there is a line PQ here, PQ. Now this line is parallel to the axis of the shaft. Now if I extend this line to the side view, the center of this shaft representing the point O, and if I extend this line Q, OQ is the radius of the shaft. So now when the torque is applied at the other end of the shaft, so due to this twisting moment, the line PQ gets shifted from Q to Q dash, that is the new position is PQ dash. So the deflection is being QQ dash. You can see that QQ dash is the deflection. You can see this point due to the application of torque in a clockwise direction. Now, if I extend this line Q, I'll mark here the Q in the side view and same Q dash extended as Q dash. Now we can see that the line PQ is shifted to PQ dash such that the angle, you can see the angle here, QP Q dash is equal to phi. So that is this angle QP Q dash is angle phi. Now this angle is called as the shear strain. This is called as the shear strain. And similarly, when you see from the, in the side view, we can see that the angle QOQ dash, that is QOQ dash, this angle is considered as theta and is called as angle of twist. So we have two angles here. One is phi, which is called as the shear strain, and the other angle theta, that is angle of twist. So the other specifications are L is length of the shaft, R is radius of the shaft, theta is angle of shift, angle of twist, phi shear strain. And here one more term, that is G is the modulus of rigidity of the material of which the shaft is made. And T is the torque in Newton millimeters. And the shear stress induced is represented by tau. Now this is the stress induced due to the torque applied on the shaft. So now, after this, let us see how this shear stress can be measured that is induced in the shaft. So the shear stress in the shaft is given by the distortion at the outer surface due to the application of torque divided by the total length of the shaft. So this distortion is shown by QQ dash. This is the distortion that has happened due to the application of torque. So that we'll write here. Distortion is QQ dash divided by the total length of the shaft. So now you can see that in this triangle, PQQ dash, now this opposite by adjacent is tan phi. So this is given by tan phi. And since the distortion is very small, the angle is also very small. The strain is very small. So the tan phi tends to phi because phi is very small. Continuing, so up to this we have done phi phi dash by L is equal to, QQ dash by L is equal to phi. So let us continue with that. QQ dash by L is equal to phi. Or QQ dash is equal to phi L. So let us take this as equation one. And also from the end view, we can write QQ dash is equal to OQ into theta. So here you can see QQ dash is the length of the sector of the arc. Okay. QQ dash is represented by the radius and the angle subtended. Radius into angle subtended gives you the length of the arc, QQ dash, which is equal to OQ into theta, that is the radius into theta. So now I can write from this equation, this QQ dash already we have taken as phi L, substituting for that phi L is equal to R theta, or phi is equal to R theta by L. So we have equation for the shear strain here. The shear strain is represented by the radius angle of twist divided by length of the shaft. So this is the expression for the shear strain. Now, coming to the modulus of rigidity. Modulus of rigidity for the shaft is defined as the ratio of shear stress to shear strain. Okay, so we can write modulus of rigidity represented by G, the ratio of shear stress to shear strain. Shear stress is tau and shear stress strain is phi. Now if I substitute for phi from this equation, R theta by L, so tau by, if I substitute for phi, R theta by L, so upon this adjustments, you can see tau into L is equal to G R theta, or tau by R is equal to G theta by L. So we have one more expression here. The ratio of shear stress to the radius is equal to the product of modulus of rigidity into angle of twist divided by L. Now let us see how this value varies. Now in this equation three, we can see that the terms G, theta and L, all these three are constant terms. Okay, fixed. So that means if I take R on the right side, the shear stress varies with respect to R. That means the shear stress value becomes minimum or maximum as you go with the change in radius. So that means when the radius is zero, that is at the center of the shaft, the shear stress tends to zero. Okay, the shear stress tends to zero at the center. And the shear stress is maximum when R reaches the maximum value, that is at the outermost surface. So we have two values of shear stress. One is zero at the center and one is maximum at the outermost surface. Now suppose that if I want to find the shear stress at any radius R from the center of the surface, somewhere at a radius R, small r. So then the relation changes to the same equation three, will take tau by R is equal to G theta by L is equal to Q by R, because we know that the shear stress varies and it is proportional with respect to the ratio of shear stress to radius changes, that is proportionally, that is Q by R. Okay, so this is, we have one relation, that is tau by R is equal to G theta by L is equal to Q by R. Coming to the second relation, that is, that gives the relation between torque and shear stress. So to do this, we'll consider a solid circular shaft. This on this right side, you can see it has a radius of capital R, and small r is the radius of a small elemental ring that we have considered here of thickness dr. The two radius, one is R is the radius of the shaft and small r is the radius of a small elemental area, hatched portion you can see, and thickness is dr. So let us take T is the torque applied, R is the radius of the shaft, capital R, then T is the applied torque, and Q is shear stress at radius R, small r, from the center, okay, small r. So shear stress induced at the outermost surface. Okay, so now let us take the area of this elemental ring, small ring, is given by delta A, that is equal to 2 pi r into dr. Okay, So that is so we can see the area of the elemental ring is 2 pi r into dr, okay, mm square, circumference area into the thickness of the elemental ring. Now in this equation, tau by r is equal to q by r, which we derived previously. I want the expression for the small shear stress at radius r. So q is equal to tau by capital R into small r. So now this is the shear stress for the elemental ring, equation number 2. Now if I want to find the force acting on this elemental area, small elemental area, that is df is equal to shear stress acting on the elemental area or ring into area of the ring. So now I'll take df is equal to the shear stress. We have already given expression from 6. This equation q is equal to tau by r into r, that I'll substitute here. And then area is 2 pi r dr already from equation 5. So now this comes to tau by r into 2 pi r square into dr. So this is the force acting on the elemental ring. Tau by r is equal to into 2 pi r square into dr. So now if after coming to know that force, I will find the torque. Torque on this elemental ring is equal to force into the distance from the center. So what is the force? Force we have this equation, tau by r into 2 pi r square dr, and distance from the center, that is small r, I'll substitute here. This is the distance. So we'll get, so this is delta t is equal to tau by r. Now this r square into r becomes 2 pi r cube into dr. So that is equation 8. Now this is the torque acting on the small elemental area. Now I want to extend this onto the entire radius of the shaft to find the total torque. So total torque is equal to applying the limits to this equation from 0 to r. 0 is the center and r is the outermost radius. So tau by r, 2 pi r cube dr, the same equation. So when we apply the integration, so these are the terms that are constant, tau by r, because we are integrating with respect to r. So tau by r, 2 pi outside. So 0 to r, so we are integrating here with respect to 0 to r, r cube dr. So now the integration becomes r 4 by 4 and within the limits 0 to r. So taking the limits r 4 by this 2 is cancelled. So 2, then the equation becomes torque is equal to pi r 4 by 2 into tau by r. So we know that the radius is half the diameter. We're substituting in place of r, I'll substitute d by 2. Then with the simplification, the equation becomes torque is equal to pi by 32 d fourth into tau by r. So now this is the total torque acting on this shaft of radius capital R. So now we know that from this equation can be written as T is equal to J into tau by R, where J is the polar moment of inertia. And for solid shaft, J is equal to pi by 32 D fourth. Hence, I'm replacing pi by 32 D fourth by J. So the equation becomes T by J is equal to tau by R. So the equation then becomes T by J by tau by r is equal to g theta by l. Okay. Now this is from the previous equation where we have t by j is equal to g theta by l, and this t by j is equal to tau by r is equal to g theta by l. Now this equation is called as the torsion equation, which gives you the relation between the torque, shear stress, and angle of twist. So this equation is very important in designing the shaft to find the diameter of the shaft.
So let us solve a simple problem on this one to find how the diameter or can be found out, or how the shaft can be designed by using the torsion equation. Let us take this problem. Determine the diameter of the shaft. So we need to find the diameter of the shaft here, design the shaft, solid shaft, which can transmit 440 kilowatts power at a speed of 280 RPM. So the maximum shear stress should be limited to 40 Newton per millimeter square. Assume the modulus of rigidity for the material of shaft as 84 kilonewton per mm square. So now in this case, let us see how the diameter of the shaft can be found and the shaft can be designed. So given values I have written here, power 44 kilowatts, 440 kilowatts, speed 280 RPM, shear stress is given, modulus of rigidity. So now we have the equation, power is equal to 2 pi nt by 60,000 kilowatts. From this, if I take the torque, so torque is equal to P into 60 into 10 to the power of 3 by 2 pi n. Now substituting the values, power 60 into 10 to the power of 3, 2 pi, speed 280. So I'll get this value of torque. We'll get in Newton meters. So because stress values are given in millimeter square, so I'll convert this into Newton millimeter multiplied by 10 to the power of 3. So the equation, the value becomes 15 into 10 to the power of 6 Newton millimeters. Now, by knowing the torque, we can design the shaft or find the diameter by applying the torsion equation. T by J is equal to tau by R is equal to G theta by L. Since we don't have the value of angle of twist, so we can design based on strength, that is T by J is equal to tau by R. So substituting the values, T is equal to 15 into 10 to the power of 6 Newton millimeters. And then J is for solid shaft, it is pi by 32 D fourth. And tau is equal to 40 into D by 2. Then if I simplify this, I will get the value of diameter, that is 124 mm. So that is how you can find the value of the diameter of the shaft. When you know the power transmitted, you can find the torque, and using the equation, torsion equation, we can find the diameter of the shaft. A shaft 8 mm diameter and 500 mm long. Shaft 80 mm diameter and 500 mm long transmits 35 kilowatts at 200 RPM. Determine the torque to be applied, then shear stress in the shaft, angle of twist. Take the modulus of rigidity as 8 into 10 to the power 4 Newton per mm square. So you can see here, this is the shaft. You can see the shaft here of diameter D. You can see the diameter. Then the length of the shaft is L, is applied with the torque T. You need to find the value of torque. Now, let us write the data first. Diameter is 80, length 500. Power to be transmitted is 35 kilowatts at a speed of 200 RPM. And the material of which the shaft is made is having a modulus of rigidity of 8 into 10 to the power 4 Newton per mm square. So we know that the equation for power transmitted is 2 pi nt by 60 into 10 to the power of 3 kilowatts. So power is given 35 kilowatts. The value of power is given. So substitute here, 35 is equal to 2 pi, speed is 200 RPM. So substitute, then unknown value is T, divided by 16 to the power 10 to the power of 3. So from this, we'll get the value of torque. So remember that this value is in Newton meters. So we need to convert into Newton millimeters because the values of stresses are in Newton per millimeter square. So substituting this, converting this from Newton meter to the Newton millimeters, you'll get 167.11 into 10 to the power of 3 Newton millimeters. Now, using the torque, we can design the shaft by using the torsion equation, which is T by J is equal to tau by R is equal to G theta by L. So I'll take the first two terms here, T by J is equal to tau by R, to find the value of the shear stress that is asked here. Torque we have found out already. Next, we have to find the shear stress. To find the shear stress, I'll use the first part of the equation, that is T by J is equal to tau by R, or tau is equal to T into R by J, where R is the radius and J is the polar moment of inertia, which is pi by 32 d fourth for a solid shaft. So substituting the value of J in this equation, we'll get tau is equal to, the value of torque is 167.11, substituting here, and radius is half the diameter, 80 by 2, and then pi by 32 d fourth. So we'll get the value of the shear stress as 1.66 Newton per mm square. So this is the shear stress induced in the shaft due to the application of torque. So we have found out the torque and the shear stress. We have found the torque, then we have found out the shear stress. Next, we need to find the angle of twist. So angle of twist is, so you can see here the angle of twist theta. Now, due to the application of torque, the line PQ is shifted from Q to Q dash. That is, PQ is shifted to PQ dash. This is the shift you can see. So now if I extend this line into the side view, I will get the angle of twist, that is theta. How to find this angle of twist? We can use the second part of the equation of the torsion equation. So that is T by J is equal to G theta by L. That means T by J is equal to G theta by L, or you can use this equation. So from this equation, rearranging the terms, theta is equal to T into L by G into J. Substituting the values, torque is 167.11 10 to the power of 3 Newton millimeters. Length of the shaft is 500. Then modulus of rigidity, 8 into 10 to the power of 4. Then J is equal to pi by 32 into 84. So from this, if you solve this, we'll get the value of theta, that is 2.59 into 10 to the power of minus 4 in radians. To convert from radians to degrees, I'll multiply by 180 by pi. So the value of theta, angle of twist, is 0.014 degree. So now, to transmit a power of 35 kilowatts at a speed 200 RPM, to restrict the twist to 0.014 degree, we need to apply the torque of 167.11 into 10 to the power of 3 Newton millimeters, provided the material that is used for the shaft is having a modulus of rigidity of 8 into 10 to the power 4 Newton per mm square. So we have found out the angle of twist also. So you can see this is the angle of twist.